My God, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord God, for this day. I just want to say to everybody, good evening. How are y'all doing today? Hope all is well. Just want you to know we give God all the glory. We want to welcome you tonight to our Tuesday night Bible study, walking through the Word, in the Word of God, because God is always speaking, and we just want you to incline your ear tonight to hear what God is saying. This is the day that the Lord has made. We got to all rejoice and be glad in it. And I just love that song. Say, sometimes you just got to encourage yourself. Sometimes we looking for encouragement for somebody else, but you got to encourage yourself in the Lord. Speak over yourself. Yes, encourage yourself in the Lord. Glory to God. I'm going to get out the way, let God get in the way and have his way. This is the day the Lord has made, and we all should just rejoice and be glad. Tonight I'm going to pray, but I want to lift up my friend, long life friend, over 37 years, Tony Baquie, who is in Los Angeles, California. She's fighting some battles. The battle, but we know that the battle is not hers with the cancer. So let's lift her up tonight in prayer. And also my cousin, my first cousin, Sister Valerie Baker. She's also going through a little battle right now. So we want to lift her up also up in the Lord, that they are covered and by his stripes they are healed. Father, tonight we just want to thank you. Tonight we praise you, our God. We lift you up and we glorify your name. God, we lift up Tony and we lift up Valerie and anyone else that is sick right now. God, we know that your word says by your stripes they are healed. And God, we stand on your word. We decree your word. We declare your word. And we trust your word. Your word says you're the God that healeth thee. And God, we just thank you tonight. And God, we pray right now that your people will incline their ear, God, to hear the word of God tonight. God, what you got to say. God, move by your spirit and move by your power. We thank you and we give you all the praise. We give you all the glory and no other name than the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen, amen. How y'all doing, New Hope? How y'all doing? How y'all feel? I just want y'all to know that we love y'all. I'm a little bit tired, but you know what? I give God praise because God say, give him praise in all things. And so I praise him. I've been kind of running a lot, but tonight we are before you all to let. I can't wait to see what God got to say tonight. So come on, Bishop, waiting on you. This is my better half.
Watch it now.
My better half.
Watch it now.
I'm better because of you.
Two halves make a whole. All right.
I'm complete now. you completed me.
Well, welcome tonight to our Breakthrough Bible Study. We thank God for you walking in the Word. Amen.
We're walking in and
through. And I'm so glad we're here tonight.
Yes, and I am too.
One of our favorite songs, got to learn how to encourage yourself. Sometimes, when nobody else will, you got to learn how to get into the mirror, look yourself in the eye, and pat your own self on your chest or on your back. Write your own self a certificate of honor, of achievement.
Yeah.
Because God has been good to you. Amen.
He's definitely been good to me, Bishop.
Yes. Listen, you know, prophetess, the devil is busy. And whenever we see this type of attacks on our community,
yes,
on the Bible, on the kingdom, and on the kingdom representatives, you know that something good is about to break in just any moment now. And we are sensing a real breakthrough that God is about to release into the kingdom. And we are praying. We are praying much for our brothers and sisters who have fallen ill, those who are hospitalized.
Amen.
Prophetess Sheila in Orlando.
Oh, yeah, good friend Sheila Spencer.
Sheila Spencer, you know, the saints are praying around the clock.
A mighty woman
and,
of God.
We believe that God is going to move on her behalf
in a miraculous
way and raise her up. Amen. And return her back to the battlefield where she can do God's work and do God's will.
Amen.
And so many others of our friends and family who have been fallen to illness and sickness. We are praying for our cousin Valerie, Person Baker. We are praying for her. We are praying for our dear sister, Tony Bacqui, Lopez, who are in Los Angeles, California. Tony, you are a woman of faith.
Yes.
And we said on the Monday, your faith have been certified. Mm. Amen. You believe God, you trusted God, and God has brought you through many dangers seen and unseen.
By God.
And God is still taking you through. So we just believe God for you, and we believe God with you. We're waiting to hear the report of victory.
Amen.
From Los Angeles. And we are praying for our families here in Miami of our fellowship. And we are praying for our friends across the country that God will keep you strong.
Amen.
And God will keep you wealthy and healthy to do his will and his work so that you can, you know, do the things that God has commissioned and assigned your hands to do.
Yes.
Much work is to be done. Much work is to be done. And you know, it don't take a whole lot of us, just a few. Many are called, but few are chosen.
Few.
And the faithful few can make the difference. So we thank God for that. Listen.
You know what?
Yes.
I just wanted to say, that was a powerful word that you spoke on Sunday morning.
My God, my God. Listen, God is dealing with us in miraculous ways. And I am more convinced than ever. Really, more convinced than ever, that he is calling us back to prayer. He is calling us back to prayer. And when the kingdom comes back into right alignment, you know, when the church prays, something good happens. Mm-hmm. When the church begins to really pray, not play, but pray, something really good begin to happen. And we talked about on Sunday, you know, the incident when Peter was in jail, Herod put him in jail overnight because of the Passover. But the church went in prayer. The church went in prayer at Mother Mary's house. And there was not a whole lot of them, but they were the church.
Mm-hmm.
You know? They were the church. Not the building, but the people who love God.
Mm-hmm.
They went in prayer on behalf of Peter. And the Bible says, you know, in different translations, which we love so much, one said that he strenuously prayed for Peter. Another one said he fervently prayed.
Fervently.
For Peter. Diligently prayed. Consistently prayed. Persistently prayed for Peter. Constant prayer was made for Peter. And one King James said prayer without ceasing was made for Peter. So Peter represented those of us who are in trouble, who are in need of prayer. You know, Peter represented everyone who stood in the need of prayer. Wherever you may be tonight, whatever your condition may be, whatever your circumstance may be, you are in need of prayer. And the church is praying for you.
I like that.
And when the church prays, God hears.
It's something about when we come together, when we're unified, when we're on one accord, when we're glued together, we're two. A three, a touching, and an agreement.
You said it. You said it best Sunday. You say, "Together we stand, but divided we fall." So, if we can ever come together, if the church can ever come together—not the building, and not the total membership—you
so
know,
much you said,
everybody on the roll is not a part of what's happening. But when the church, the believers, the true baptized, born again believers, who trust God with all their heart, who believe God for what His Word says. When that church come together, two or three, Jesus said he'd be in the midst. So what would happen when 4 or 5, 10, 12, 20, 25, 50, 100 of us come together?
Wow.
There's going to be a major shaking and a major move. So I know the devil is horrified. He is scared because the church is actually praying. I feel it.
Oh, yeah.
I feel the prayers of the prayers of the righteous availeth much.
I'm telling you. I always say that. Much prayer.
Much power.
Little prayer.
Little power.
No prayer.
No kind of power.
So you need some power and you want some Holy Ghost power. You get in the face of God, get in a position, get in the posture, in a place where you can hear from God, and you can hear from God, and you can talk to God, where there's no distraction. It's just me. I stand in the need of, and it's just something. Yes, we do our private prayer. I do my private prayer, but it's something about when the man of God, he's calling for the corporate, the body of Christ, for us to come together, to be unified, joined together,
touching and agreeing.
Yeah, when
in
we
the
join,
spirit. We don't have to be in the same vicinity, but we must be in the same realm, the same region in the spirit. You see, if we can just get in the same place in the spirit, I don't have to be right where you are. You don't have to be right where I am, but we can touch, agree in the spirit. Amen. Why? Because God is a spirit. God is a spirit. He don't just move in buildings. He moves in the spiritual realm. So when we touch, agree in the spirit, there is no limitation as to what God can do.
We got to worship in spirit and in truth.
In spirit and in truth. Yeah. Amen. So we're locking in. We're locking in more than ever. Mm-hmm. And if we haven't learned anything else during this pandemic, we should have learned by now how to pray.
And I'm telling you, it's been amazing because it's been 18 months, and I didn't realize it was 18 months that Bishop, he summons us as the body believing the church, New Hope, to come together. And we had to do it from the conference of our home, where then you get on, you put your phone on mute, and you get on, and then we asking different ones to come in and pray. And those that have been steadfast, been faithful, been loyal, been diligent, you can see how they have matured. There's different levels of, and when we pray and when we talk, just like different levels in your job with the CEOs, we have different status and stuff. The same thing, like the mother, the father. In the home with dads, the head.
Listen, prophet. Listen. The anointing is what destroys the yokes, and what we have experienced over these past 18 months, as the body of Christ came together, whether it was in one place or over the phone, you know, we heard their voices, and we felt their presence.
Yes.
And the anointing of the Holy Ghost begin to move.
Yes.
And we have seen people's prayer shift and their prayer change and their prayer have such an anointing on it until you can see the camaraderie. You can see the common good that coming together as we pray. And that 1 hour go by so quick.
It go by so fast.
I mean, everybody, you know, I want to hear everybody pray. Everybody just can't pray at one time. But when you call on the name, listen, they are ripe and ready
and they're
to
ready
pray.
To go.
They are
and,
ready
and
to go in.
You can see the growth level. You
press
know, like,
in.
It's like anything when you first, if you don't do it a lot, you kind of like the enemy try to make you feel fearful or afraid. But you see those who was, they started out and now they like gone.
Oh, they're ready.
And I'm just, I have been so blessed, tremendously blessed. And I just thank God. So when I get going, I'm going through something. You know who to go to.
And we thank God for the saints who are inviting new people.
Yes.
Listen, folks on this prayer, corporate prayer, from the north to the south and the Midwest, from the east to the west, all across America. Listen, New Hope, it's working. Saints, it is working. And I just believe that there's a major move about to take place. Matter of fact, it's already happening. We just haven't come into full knowledge of it yet, but I know God is already moving. He's not stale. He's not stagnant. He's already moving. But it's gonna come to pass. And we're gonna see it together.
Amen.
We're gonna see it together. So I'm excited. I'm excited for what God is doing. And I can't move forward without saying again, happy birthday to my father-in-law, Mr. Clyde Ernest Kincaid. 94 years old.
94.
Yeah, still pontificating, still ordering us around.
Yeah, dad's birthday was
calling
yesterday.
The shots, I tell you. So we want to say happy birthday to Pop. Yeah. Amen. And we wish you well with many more years to come.
And my dad and his father's birthday was on the same day.
Right. Yeah. So that's a blessing. Yeah. It looks just like his dad too.
Yeah, exactly.
Amen. Looks just like Tom. So let's get to the word. Listen. Last week, we had a chance to talk about the law of common golden connections, uncommon golden connections. And we start talking about some nuggets in there as to what it would take for us to have what is called a golden connection. Amen. We talked about, go ahead.
No, I'm just saying who you connected with.
Yeah, it's all important. It's important. Who you connect with can make the difference between life and death.
My God.
It's the difference between right and wrong. Mm. It's the difference between prospering or living in lack. Based upon who you hang out with and who you connect with. You know, you got to watch, you know, who you join forces with. Amen. We talked about the importance of having good mentors, having proteges, having friends, having enemies.
Wow.
How God can even use your enemies to be a blessing to you. And then we talked about that golden connection. That golden connection. So to recognize that you have a golden connection can unleash waves of uncommon favor and uncommon miracles in your life. When you have a golden connection, it have a way of unleashing and releasing. Listen, uncommon favor and uncommon miracles in your life and over your life. And I believe every one of us stand in need of a miracle tonight.
I like that, what you just said. And then it says, and then the thing about why you had to recognize them, because it say if you fail to recognize them, what happens?
Yeah, what happens?
It say if you fail to recognize them as a gift from God, you will abort 1,000 miracles that God has for you in your life. You can abort them. You miss them.
Yeah, you'll miss out. You'll miss out on what God has purposed and planned for your life.
Yeah.
It goes all the way back to Jeremiah 29:11. He says, I know the thoughts I think toward you, says the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you a future and to bring you into an expected hope. So God said, I know the plans and I know the thoughts that I think toward you. God has a purpose and a plan for our lives, has a purpose, a divine purpose, and a divine plan for our lives. And if we just stay connected with him, amen, in his word, in the spirit, in his word, and in the spirit, then we can receive the favor and the blessings that God has purpose and plan for us to have.
Mm.
But you got to stay connected. Because in the Gospel of John, it says this. He says, without me, you can do what?
Nothing.
You can do nothing. For without me, you can do nothing. So you got to stay connected. We got to stay connected to God. And how do we stay connected? We stay connected through the word.
Mm-hmm.
We stay connected in the spirit.
In prayer.
We stay connected in prayer.
Mm-hmm.
We stay connected in praise and in worship.
And forsaking not the
assembling of yourselves together.
Yeah, uh-huh.
So we don't just become absentee worshipers. No, we connect. And we get involved gladly.
And one thing what I think about too, a connection too, when husband and wife or anybody, when you come together and stuff like that, and then that's how birth and children are born, when we're connected in the, you know, in that time, the intimacy.
Yeah.
It's an intimacy, and we got to have an intimacy also with God, and that's how other reproductive
dreams
come forth.
Dreams are birthed when two get together and agree and find common ground. We can now set a path to realize our dreams and aspirations.
Mm-hmm.
We learn how to sacrifice, how to say no to some things in order to get some things.
Mm-hmm.
You learn how to alter your time, your schedule, how to adjust your day in order to arrive at a point in your life when you can say, you know what? We finally got there.
And one thing, you cannot, be blessed without a golden connection, without connecting to somebody. You cannot. You cannot succeed alone by yourself. You need somebody. You got to be connected to somebody to take you to that next level, to help you to get there.
And thank God we're connected to God.
Yes.
You know, we're connected to God. And God will put people in your path. I always say this in my teachings and in my preaching. I always say this. God will put people in your path
to do what?
To be a blessing in your life.
Thank you.
He told Abram, He said, Abram, I want you to leave your family, your father, your family, your friends, your familiar surroundings, and go search for a city whose builder and maker is God. And here's the promise. He says, I will bless them that blesses you, and I will curse him that curseth you. So God has people already put placed in our path, waiting for us to get to the next intersection of benefits and blessings so he can release into our lives. God is waiting. God got this thing hooked up, y'all. Listen, saints, God has this thing hooked up. And he's just waiting on us to get in right alignment for time to intersect with eternity so he can release what he has purposed and planned into our lives. You know, before we go into this Golden Connections again, I got to bring this back. Last week we talked about the seed. Remember the seed? The faith seed, the seed of faith. We talked about God's going to give you some seed to participate in the process promulgated by him. This is seed faith. So when your seed cooperate with your faith, your uncommon seed match up with your uncommon faith, then God can release uncommon favor in your life.
My God.
So if you want the favor of God, you got to participate and stay connected. And sow that seed that God has given you. Release your faith for what God has purposed and planned for you so that you can receive the uncommon favor upon your life.
You got to release.
Yes, you got to release it. And therefore, you want people around you that can help you to release.
He said something else you were saying about to complete your assignment on earth, you needed, it was five things I think you needed last time. It said about a mentor, a protege, and something
you need,
like that.
You need mentors, you need proteges, you need friends, you need enemies, and you need, we got to have golden connections. Not one connection, but golden connections. Now listen, sometimes God put people in your life for a season. They connect with you for a season. That's the only reason they connected was for that season. And when that season is over, it's time for you to move on, and it's time for them to move on.
And
it's not permanent.
Right.
It's not permanent. So you got to recognize that some people are just seasonal connections. Others are permanent connections. You know, a mother and father, we have children, right? We have permanent connections. They can grow, they can get grown, they can mess up, come back, we can still be mom and daddy. But then there are some people in our life who are seasonal connections.
They're seasonal. And then you got people in there just to mentor you, to help you. Things to mentor you, who changes, to help change you.
And once they help make you, mold you, shape you, then it's time for you to go on and do what you got to do, and they move on to somebody else too. Those are seasonal. Your teacher was seasonal.
Exactly.
Your instructors in college were seasonal.
Exactly.
Your supervisors on your job were seasonal.
Exactly.
To help motivate you, craft you, to get to where you need to go. Now, you should have all the skills and all the skill sets to do what needs to be done to be a blessing to your family.
And other thing, too, he said, you need a protege. Those are people in your life that challenge you. You know, like sometimes you don't, we don't like to be, you know, the challenges. They challenge you. You can do that.
Mentors change you. Proteges challenge you. See, so some folk gonna have to challenge you to be the best you. There's a better you in you. There's a better you in you. And someone needs to challenge you to be the best you that you can be.
My God.
And don't just acquiesce. Don't just, agree or settle for less. There's a better you waiting to come forth. There's more in you than what you know. There's more in you waiting to come forth. And you need someone to challenge you to come on, say, come on, you can do it. Yeah. Come on, just go the extra mile. Give me a little bit more. A little bit more. Oh, you can do this.
Yeah.
You're not tired. You know,
it's in you.
That's right.
It's in you. God has placed it in you. You're one of a kind. No one else has your DNA. God has placed something in you unique. No one else has your handprint. It's different. You are different. You was born for this.
So we need golden connections.
You need some friends too.
Those are connections.
Yeah,
we need golden connections. Now, everyone that you meet in this world is not going to be golden. Some are going to be sour. Some are going to be rotten.
Yeah.
So you got to learn how to separate the good from the bad.
But that's why we have our friends, those that true friends, real friends, they there to comfort you.
When
you get the most sour, you know, those sour potatoes.
A golden connection, listen, a golden connection would never get envious or jealous because you're being promoted.
They celebrate you.
They'll celebrate you.
Mm-hmm.
They won't never try to distract you or try to demote you or try to devalue you. A golden connection in your life will always celebrate you and encourage you and empower you
and build you
to
up.
Be the best you that you can be. And once you've gotten to that point, they're willing to release you to go ahead and fly.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead and fly. Go ahead and sail, you know, to the next level. Mm-hmm. So golden connections, plural, plural. Number 12. Talked about this last week. The golden connections may not become obvious until years later. Mm. You may not recognize how valuable
the golden connection
that person was in your life until years later.
Mm.
Years later. I mean, they don't pour into you. They don't done all they can do. And they've released you. And now you're on your own.
Mm-hmm.
And finally now, something happens in life. Something calls you to have a recall of your experience that prepared you for that moment, and when you get through it, you remember, you know what? Such and such really prepared me for this.
That's like the butler. We said last week, the butler was a link to Pharaoh, but he forgot Joseph for 2 years. Remember when he went in, I think it was prison, he was in Joseph was in there.
Mm-hmm.
The intercession of, I think it was Abraham, brought deliverance to Lot after they pardoned company for us. It was a while.
Yeah. Years later, you recall somebody who was extremely good to you, who really poured into your life.
God bring it back to your memory.
Who really made a difference, you know, I mean, and you would never forget that person. I had one such person in my life, really. When I was, I always remember every teacher who poured it to me. Yes, who poured it to me. I know my first grade, second grade, third grade, fourth grade, fifth grade, sixth grade teacher. My sixth grade teacher, her name was Miss Edna Stark.
Okay.
And she said to us in class one day, she asked the class, what do you want to be when you grow up? Some said baseball player, football player, fireman, and policeman. She asked me, I said, I want to be a banker.
You want to handle money, huh?
She said, a banker? I said, yes, ma'am. She said, why you want to be a banker? I said, because my mom and dad don't have money, and when I get it, I want to know what to do with it.
Mm-hmm.
And she said, well, you're going to be a banker. And guess what? Because I heard that word, I was laser focused. And after sixth grade, I went through middle school, college, I went through high school and college. And my degree, when I graduated from the University of Florida, was in banking and finance.
She spoke in your life.
I never forgot that. That was my dream.
And it took root.
And God put people in my path along the way to help me to realize my dream.
Yes, yes.
Yes, sir.
God would do it every time.
He'd do it every time. So golden connections may not become obvious until years later. Number 13, golden connections may be discerned instantly.
How is that?
Golden connections may be discerned instantly. It happened between David and Jonathan. Jonathan and David had a golden connection. He sensed, he saw that Jonathan was his best friend.
Wow.
Instantly. He didn't have to wait. And sometimes God will put those kind of people in your life where you will meet them. Some people meet in the strangest of places. They'll meet while shopping. They'll meet while having a dinner or having, you know, a conversation.
You know what? You said that was instantly. That kind of remind me of you in high school. I mean, we was in school and you saw me and you just went, oh, that's going to be my wife. I ain't gonna marry you. Following me and I was ducking you and everything, you know, like that.
You just couldn't help yourself, could you?
She
couldn't help herself, y'all. It was instantly engrafted. I was her golden connection. I didn't have no money, but I told her, I said, look, girl, if you just stick with me, I'll give you a proper wedding one day and I'll give you all your dreams.
August the 30th this year. August 30th, right?
August the 30th.
It'll be 46 years.
46 years. Yes.
Won't he do it?
Every time. He'll connect you.
Good God Almighty.
So sometimes it's discerned instantly. Number 14, the golden connections may happen quickly with someone else you have never met before. It may happen with someone that you have never, ever met before. Why? That's easy. That's an easy question, easy answer. Because God knows what we need. And God will put people in your path for a season to be a blessing in your life.
My God.
I'm going to bring this to pass. Listen, you remember when the prophet Elijah was running from King Ahab, and he was being fed by the brook called Cherith. He had fresh water to drink. A raven would bring him food morning and night. And one day, the brook dried up. The brook dried up, and the raven didn't bring no more food. God said to him, get down to Zarephath. He said, I have a widow woman there who will sustain thee during the rest of this famine. Never met her. He never met her.
Wow.
But God had placed a widow woman in his path to be a blessing in his life.
Had already touched her heart.
Already touched her heart. She couldn't say no. So God got people that he have already put in your path that can't tell you no.
You ain't never met them before.
You don't even know their name yet.
Yeah.
Don't even know what they look like yet.
So some of y'all out there, you getting ready to meet somebody.
Yes. If you just be faithful to God. If you just be faithful to God and faithful to his work. Listen, he will put people in your path who will be a blessing in your life. He will give you the hookup with folks that you don't even know. They don't know you.
Sometimes we get so upset because we think who the people we think want to do it for us and help us.
Yeah.
They're not the one. God has already touched somebody. And all you got to do is just stay faithful to him and keep in the have faith in him. And God will do it every single time. I'm a living witness. God will put other people in your mouth, in your place, to do what sometimes you think is your own family. It don't necessarily be them.
If you have a desire, if you have a spirit that want to do what God has told you to do, want to fulfill the mandate that God has placed in your life, God will put people in your path who will pour into you, be a blessing to you. You never met them. You don't even know them. But they're people of influence. But once they see you, watch this, and hear your name, lights go off.
It's going to be instantly.
Instantly. They start moving heaven and earth to be a blessing, to open a door for you. Listen, you're gonna write me back on that. Send me some love on that one. Because it's going to happen this week. It's going to happen this week. And you're going to see it. In the middle of this pandemic, God is going to do it just for you. Just to show you that he is God all by himself. My. Number 15. Your golden connections may not recognize your value until the passage of time.
It's not always right away.
Your golden connection may not recognize your value until the passage of time. You see, the people that you're going to come in contact with don't know how blessed you are or how well prepared you are,
Lord,
or how valuable you are. Listen, saints, when you walk into a building, the atmosphere changes. When you show up to work, the atmosphere changes. Things get better because of you and your faithfulness to God. And because favor is on your life, wherever you go, favor is on the environment that you work in.
Thank you, Lord. It's already there.
It's already there.
It's on you.
Things shift because of you.
That because of that place, and you've been in the presence of God. You've been connected to your faith, connected in prayer, connected in the word of God. You've been connected. You've been steadfast. You've been obedient. You did right by your parents. You did right by your children. You did right by people. Now God's going to do right with you. The favor of God is on you. It's a done deal.
You're the salt of the earth.
Yeah.
You're the light of the world. So whenever you show up, light and salt, preservation shows up. And therefore, You give flavor. You, your life and your presence give flavor to the situation.
My God.
Things that was hard becomes easy because of you. Things that couldn't be done stop being worked out because of you.
They see something in you.
Yes. And people will say, you know what? I didn't know they were that valuable.
Mm-hmm. But God has placed that in you. He put that in there.
He put that on you. You got that anointing on you. You got that favor on you. You see? That's the favor and the anointing. That's the uncommon favor. Because you sowed the uncommon seed. You mixed that seed with faith. And now here goes the uncommon favor. Doors are opening. People are being generous.
Yeah, be not dismayed. Never be cut. God will.
Number 16.
Whatever's in you.
The golden connection may be nameless.
Powerless.
May be powerless and even appear insignificant. In other words, from your eyes to them, don't judge the book by its cover.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
They may look like they're not important, but God know how important they are to you. Again, a widow woman.
My God.
Picking up sticks to go and cook a meal for her son and die. And the prophet recognized the word of God and said to her, listen, would you go and make me a whole cake first?
Yes.
And she said, you must understand.
I'm
just picking up sticks to go make a, I have a little oil and a little meal, and I'm going in to cook a meal for me and my son. We're going to eat it and die.
My God.
And the prophet said to her, I understand what you're going to do. Go ahead, but make me one first and bring it back.
My God.
And she obeyed. Obedience will bring you to the door of blessings.
My God. And
that, obedience will bring you to the door of blessings.
And that little boy who had them two fish.
Oh, my God. We're going to leave it out. Yeah. So the woman brought him one back first, put it in the prophet's hand.
Okay.
And she went back. And she didn't have no more, but when she dipped into the meal barrel, guess what came out? When she dipped the oil crude, guess what came out?
It just kept pouring.
And she ate for many days until the famine was over.
When God's hands is in it, and you in his hand, honey, God take nothing and he make it more than enough.
They may look insignificant, they may look powerless, they may be nameless, but what they have can be a blessing in your life. And you just mentioned it right then. This little boy who had two fish and five loaves, barley loaves. Mm-hmm. One writer say barely loaves. And what was that among 5,000?
It was a whole lot.
That's what
Jesus,
the disciples say, what is this among 5,000? He's powerless, he's nameless, he's insignificant. Jesus said, that's all right, give me what you got. He took that two fish and five loaves, he gave thanks, and he fed 5,000 plus men, women, boys, and girls.
But look, what's the other little lad name? The one with the he had the slingshot.
David and Goliath.
That's a golden connection. Ain't no way to little pedal on a slingshot. And he hit it in the right place.
And knocked that giant down.
That's a golden connection. He had a connection with God.
God will put people in your path.
The sheep.
Who will be a blessing in your life.
Taking care of the sheep.
But don't let your eyes, your own eyes, and your own head and mind
rob you
of someone that God has for you, because they don't look the part. Or they don't measure up like others do. Sometimes God put people of lesser stature in the room of great stature so that he can show who his power is.
When you keep saying that, I'm just thinking, boy, that lady too, that was a connection too. When that, she just said, the widow woman, if I could just touch
the hem of his
garment. That was a golden connection. Good God, been sick for 12 long years, but she had enough of faith in her. Jesus arose in her. If I can touch, she didn't want to touch anybody, but if I can touch, a whole lot of folks was touching him. But when she touched him, there's something in her. I done everything I know how to do. I done gave it. I done spent it out. I ain't got no more. All I got is my finger. If I can just touch a little part of him, I know. I believe with all my heart. It's something about this man. This man is different. He walk different. He talk different. He teach different. He's different. And if I can touch him, and that's how I feel today. Somebody out there, you need to touch him.
My God, my God, my God. Number 17, it's getting better, guys. Your access, write this one down. Your access to the golden connection may be opposed. your access, trying to get to your golden connection may be opposed. Somebody may try to block you and stop you. There will always be someone who despises your relationship to the golden connection. There will always be somebody who despises your relationships to the golden connection. So what do? They sow seeds of discord. They'll try to lock you out by messing with your mind or discrediting the value of your golden connection.
Backstabbing you.
So, listen, when people start, when you know that God has put you in a place that God may bless you, don't let nobody move you from that connection. Because that's the connection God gave you. They're just jealous. They're jealous because they don't have it. They're envious because they don't have it. They're mad at you because you got it and they don't. They oppose, amen, they oppose your golden connection.
A golden connection, too. It's like when we get to church, a golden connection to me, Bishop, when you said during this pandemic, we in a pandemic. You call a summons for us to come. The church is another avenue. No, we're not going to the building, but if we can just get ourselves up in the morning and get on the prayer line, and connect with other faith believers, other intercessors, and begin to pray. That is a golden connection where we get in that place and talk to God and cry out to God. Because by thy land, if my people call by my name,
open themselves and pray,
and turn
from their wicked ways,
then
he will hear
from heaven
and heal the land.
And heal their land. So that's a connection. And some of us haven't got on the connection yet. We don't understand. We just still doing the same thing. And he said, y'all didn't get it now. Okay, I'm putting another variant, something else finna come. Because we don't get it. And you got to get in out of your place and get in the place where God wants.
The reason they didn't get it is because they listened to those who opposed it.
My God.
They listened to those who opposed the connection. So what you got to do is say, you know what? All right, I didn't get in. I didn't get a part of it. And I'm still suffering. Maybe because you've been listening to the wrong people. If you get into your golden connection, relief and blessings and flavor will hit your house. That's when healings and miracles shows up at your house. Because you're in the right place where God has purpose and plan for you to be. 18, listen.
Oh, Bishop,
the purpose of the golden connection is to perpetuate and complete the plan of God for your life. The purpose of the golden connection is to complete the plan of God for your life. My God. God has a plan. God has planned your future. He links you with those who will help you make changes. The butler perpetuated the plan by linking Joseph to Pharaoh in the palace.
Wow.
God had a plan for Joseph, and he used the butler to get him to Pharaoh. You see, when God has a plan and a purpose for your life, he will put people and put processes in motion.
So
that you can fulfill God's purpose and plan in your life.
To perpetuate, get you there.
Yes. He moved things around. He put things in order. He put you in the right place. He make people come. He make people be placed in your path where you can't miss them.
Link y'all together.
Yes.
Bring you together.
Yes.
This is the person
it's
I need.
It's the timing of God. It's the kairos. It's the timing of God. You know, you think it's just another meeting. No, that's God's plan to fulfill his purpose. It's not just another meeting. It's a meeting of purpose.
And Bishop, the way for us to get into this place and we don't miss our connection, we got to be in that place and put God first in our lives.
Let me prophesy to our daughter, Felicia. This past weekend was a meeting of purpose, a plan of purpose to put you in a season, in a place where God can jettison you to your next dimension. That's why the people that came in contact with you didn't understand your value. They saw you, but they misunderstood your value. And that's what happens when people don't understand your value, who you are. Listen, you're a child of God.
They don't understand your value. They try to disvalue you. God. They try to put you
down. You're a child of the King.
Yeah.
And God's purpose, he said, he would not withhold no good thing from you.
He would never hold any good thing from you. When you put God first, that's why he says, seek ye first.
I will not withhold no good thing from you.
That's the connection when God is telling us to seek ye first.
The kingdom.
Of heaven and his righteousness. That is a golden connection.
And all these things.
And when all these other things that you be going after and trying to get them all other way. You ain't got to kill nobody. You ain't got to steal. You don't have a backstab. All you got to do is seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness and all these things. That is the greatest connection that we all can have. Putting God first. Early will I seek him. Early, early, not late. The early bird catch the worms. You got to be first. Put him first. He's a jealous God. That's a connection.
Listen.
A mighty
God
connection.
God sent his word and healed them. God sent his word and healed them.
All of their disease.
By his stripes,
we are healed.
He was bruised for our iniquities.
And
the chastisement of our peace was upon him. And by his stripes,
we are healed.
Jesus is our golden connection. And since we are connected to Jesus, everything, every blessing, every promise, every purpose that God has for us is fulfilled through our connection.
Yes.
The devil don't like it, but he can't stop it.
You can't. Bishop, too. Some of us, we need to, those connections that you connected with, it's time for you to disconnect. Disconnect. Because they leading you down the road, the wrong road of destruction. I just heard God leading you down the road. Some of you need to disconnect and get reconnected on the right road with the right thing, with the right people. Right now. God is talking to you right now. There's somebody out there right now.
I feel the anointing right here, prophets. I really do. I feel it tonight. This has been a turning point. I told you guys at the very outset, I sense God is doing something. I sense God is doing something magnificent. And I really do. And I know that this is a turning point for somebody tonight who's listening to my voice, who heard this word tonight. You are a part of God's divine plan.
Yes.
And God is going to fulfill his purpose in your life if you just stay connected. Stay connected through prayer, through his word, worship and praise. Hook up with somebody who's going the same direction. Amen. Understand that everybody in your life is not there for always. Some people are there just for a season, and that's good. Once that season's fulfilled, move on.
And another thing, Bishop's saying that, but I just hear the Lord. When we're disconnected and we stay disconnected and we won't get back in right alignment, the disconnected. Sometimes it can cause a premature upset or a death. And some of you, God is telling you now, he's speaking to you. I know he's speaking to you. Your heart, for you to line back up. You got off track. He's giving you time to get back on track, get back on the right road, and do the right thing. And God's going to bless you.
Let us pray. Father, in Jesus' name, God, we thank you tonight. And God, we give your name praise, we give your name glory, and give your name honor. Thank you, God, for this word tonight. I pray right now fervently, God, for my brothers and sisters across this land, a part of our fellowship, that we will come back into right alignment with your will and your word. God, I know you have a plan and a purpose for our life. Destiny is waiting, oh God. You have blessings that eyes have not seen and ears have not heard. Neither have they entered the hearts of men, all the good things you have in store for us. But God, we want to receive them, and we want to handle them, God. We want to touch them. We want to know that they are there for us. Help us to make the right decisions.
I know, Lord.
Help us to get in the right place, in the right position. Help us, God, to cherish the right connection that you have given us so that we can prosper and be in health. Even as our soul prosper. Now, God, we pray for those who are hurting tonight in their bodies, those who are lying in the hospitals, God, not even knowing their name. But, God, you know who they are. You know what they need. God, move by your spirit. Send your anointing. God, you don't have to tell us anything. God, just send your word. You promise that you will send your word and will heal our land.
Yes.
God, someone need a miracle tonight. Someone needs to be saved and set free.
Lord, we thank you.
Someone needs to be healed. Someone is hurting, need to be calm.
God,
move by your spirit. Touch, heal, and deliver in the name of Jesus. And God, we thank you. And we praise
you.
And we give your name glory. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Prophetess, close us out.
God, we just thank you for this golden connection tonight that you're ushering in a new generation of champions, God. New people, God. We just praise you and we glorify you. God, to help us to stay connected to the right people, God, that will take us higher. God, for your glory. God, we give you glory and we give you praise. And we thank you for this word, God. God, we pray that your people continue to go forward in what you call them to do. God, this day, in Jesus' name, amen. Thank y'all. We love you. Tomorrow morning, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday from 6 to 7. We have been doing this for 18 months now. And you can come and join in 6 to 7. All, you don't have to say a thing. Just put the phone on mute and let it just go in the atmosphere of the house. Let the anointing, let the prayers just bombard your home. God, and just watch over you. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord. Much prayer, much power. Little prayer, little power. We'll see you all. We love you. God bless each and every one of you all tonight. Till we see you again. Step on the back.